In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
My dear brothers and sisters, on this day, we remember the first time that Our Lady appeared to three children in Fatima. For 6 months, she will be appearing before them. We thank the Lord for assuring us that He has not abandoned us, and that Mary is always guiding her children. To make ourselves less unworthy of this Eucharistic celebration, let us acknowledge our sins and our need for conversion, and ask God's pardon and mercy. I confess to Almighty God,
and to you, my brothers and sisters, that I have greatly sinned in my thoughts and in my words, in what I have done and in what I have failed to do, through my most grievous fault. Therefore, I ask Blessed Mary, Ever Virgin, all the angels and saints, and you, my brothers and sisters, to pray for me to the Lord our God.
May Almighty God have mercy on us, forgive us our sins, and bring us to everlasting life.
Amen.
Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
Christ, have mercy.
Christ, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
Let us pray. O God, who chose the mother of your Son to be our mother also, grant us that persevering in penance and prayer for the salvation of the world, we may further more effectively each day the reign of Christ, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, God, forever and ever.
Amen. Please be seated.
A reading from the Acts of the Apostles. While Apollos was in Corinth, Paul traveled through the interior of the country and down to Ephesus, where he found some disciples. He said to them, "Did you receive the Holy Spirit when you became believers?" They answered him, "We have never even heard that there is a Holy Spirit." He said, "How were you baptized?" They replied, "With the baptism of John." Paul then said, "John baptized with the baptism of repentance, telling the people to believe in the one who was to come after him, that is, in Jesus." When they heard this, they were baptized in the name of the Lord Jesus. And when Paul laid his hands on them, the Holy Spirit came upon them, and they spoke in tongues and prophesied. Altogether, there were about 12 men. He entered the synagogue, and for 3 months debated boldly with persuasive arguments about the kingdom of God. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Sing to God, O kingdoms of the earth.
Sing to God, O kingdoms of the earth.
God arises, his enemies are scattered, and those who hate him flee before him. As smoke is driven away, so are they driven, as wax melts before the fire.
Sing to God, O kingdoms of the earth.
But the just rejoice and exult before God. They are glad and rejoice. Sing to God, chant praise to his names, whose name is the Lord.
Sing to God, O kingdoms of the earth.
The father of orphans and the defender of widows is God in his holy dwelling. God gives a home to the forsaken. He leads forth prisoners to prosperity.
Sing to God, O kingdoms of the earth. Please stand.
If then you will raise with Christ, seek what is above, where Christ is seated at the right hand of God.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
A reading from the Holy Gospel according to John.
Glory to you, O Lord.
The disciples said to Jesus, "Now you are talking plainly and not in any figure of speech. Now we realize that you know everything and that you do not need to have anyone question you. Because of this, we believe that you came from God." Jesus answered them, "Do you believe now? Behold, the hour is coming and has arrived when each of you will be scattered to his own home and you will leave me alone. But I am not alone, because the Father is with me. I have told you this so that you might have peace in me. In the world, you will have trouble, but take courage. I have conquered the world." The Gospel of the Lord.
Praise to you, Lord Jesus Christ. Please be seated.
In 1917, when Our Lady first appeared to three children in Fatima, the First World War was ongoing. And in the following year, 1918, the Spanish flu came and brought about misery and death to many people. First World War, Spanish flu. 107 years after, meaning today, there is still ongoing war, but not in the scope of a world war, but as according to Pope Francis, scattered wars. There is ongoing war in Ukraine. There is ongoing war in Gaza. There are conflicts all over the world. And we have just come out of COVID-19 pandemic. 107 years, the world has not changed that much. What has not changed in the last 107 years? One, our need for conversion. Tuloy-tuloy po yun. Yung paanyaya ng Panginoon, yung paanyaya ng mahal na Birhen na magbalik loob sa Diyos. Because if we analyze it, much of our sufferings today, much of the conflicts today that are happening are rooted in lack of conversion. Kaya nagkakaloko-loko ang buhay natin kasi ayaw nating magbalik loob. Itinuturo sa atin ng Panginoon, itinuturo sa atin ng Diyos ang landas, itinuturo sa atin ng mahal na Birhen ang daan, pero pinipili pa rin nating tumahak sa landas na gusto natin. If we want to change the world, the change must begin first with us. There is need for conversion. That is why the call of Our Lady of Fatima remains to be valid even today. Pray for conversion, not only of Russia, but of everyone. Conversion. That has not changed. The second that has not changed is this, the assurance of Our Lady's presence, the assurance of Our Lady's intercession. In Fatima, 107 years ago, the Lady assured the children, "I will be with you." Today, the Lord and the Lady, Our Lady, continue to assure us, "I will be with you." So hindi nagbabago yon ang katiyakan ng Diyos na hindi niya tayo iiwan. You know, in the Gospel of today, the Lord is telling us that life will not always be easy. Life will not always be smooth. In the world, you will have trouble. You will have trouble. The Lord has said that. Life will not always be easy and smooth. But take courage. Take courage. The Lord said, "I have conquered the world." Ang sinasabi ng Panginoon, hindi sa lahat ng oras magiging maayos ang takbo ng ating buhay. Daraan tayo sa mga pagsubok. Magpapasan tayo ng mga mabibigat na problema. Pero, ang sabi ng Panginoon, "Huwag kayong mag-alala. Nagtagumpay na ako. Nagtagumpay na ako. I have conquered the world." And so, my dear brothers and sisters, on this day, when we remember the first apparition of Our Lady in Fatima, we are being reminded of two things: the need for conversion and the assurance that Our Lady and Our Lord will continue to be with us. Amen.
Please stand.
We continue to pray for rain. God, our loving Father, creator of our earth and of the universe, and of all the wondrous elements of nature that sustain your living creatures, we humbly ask you to grant us relief from the extreme heat that besets your people at this time, disrupting their activities and threatening their lives and livelihood. Send us rain to replenish our depleting water sources, to irrigate our fields, to stave off water and power shortages, and to provide water for our daily needs. At your command, the wind and the seas obey. Raise your hand, Almighty God, to avert the continuing rise in temperatures, so that your people can engage in productive undertakings and our young people can pursue learning in tranquility and comfort. Merciful and generous God, open our eyes to the richness and beauty of your creation and instill in us a deep love for this earth and all that is in and around it. Teach us to be wise stewards of your creation, so that we may always use them responsibly and protect them from abuse and exploitation. At this time of crisis, dear Lord, move us to share more, to serve more, and to love more. Loving God, Father of our Lord Jesus Christ, you entrusted the Filipino people to the special care of Mary, our Mother. Listen to the prayers that we bring up to her, our Blessed Mother, to intercede for us for the protection of our land and our people, whom she loves. Grant this to our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, God, forever and ever. Amen. Our Lady of Guadalupe,
pray for us.
Saint Rose of Lima,
pray for us.
Saint Lorenzo Ruiz,
pray for us.
Saint Pedro Calungsod,
pray for us. Please be seated.
Blessed are you, Lord God of all creation, through goodness we have this bread to offer, which earth has given and human hands have made. It will become for us the bread of life.
Blessed be God forever.
Blessed are you, Lord God of all creation, through goodness we have this wine to offer, fruit of the vine and work of human hands. It will become our spiritual drink.
Blessed be God forever. Please stand.
Pray, my dear sisters and brothers, that my sacrifice and yours may be acceptable to God, the Almighty Father.
May the Lord accept the sacrifice at your hands for the praise and glory of His name, for our good and the good of all His holy Church.
Receive, Holy Father, this offering of our humility, which we bring you with joy, as we commemorate the Blessed Virgin Mary. And grant, we pray, that it may be for us, who are joined to the sacrifice of Christ, our consolation on earth and our eternal salvation, who lives and reigns forever and ever.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Lift up your hearts.
We lift them up to the Lord.
Let us give thanks to the Lord our God.
It is right and just.
It is truly right and just, our duty and our salvation, to praise your mighty deeds in the exaltation of all the saints, and especially as we celebrate the memory of the Blessed Virgin Mary, to proclaim your kindness as we echo her thankful hymn of praise. For truly, even to earth's ends, you have done great things and extended your abundant mercy from age to age. When you look on the lowliness of your handmaid, you gave us, through her, the author of our salvation, your Son, Jesus Christ, our Lord. Through him, the host of angels adores your majesty, and rejoices in your presence forever. May our voices, we pray, join with theirs in one chorus of exultant praise as we acclaim,
Holy, holy, holy Lord God of hosts, heaven and earth are full of your glory. Hosanna in the highest. Blessed is he who comes in the name of the Lord. Hosanna in the highest. Please kneel.
You are indeed holy, O Lord, the fount of all holiness. Make holy, therefore, these gifts, we pray, by sending down your Spirit upon them like the dewfall, so that they may become for us the body and blood of our Lord Jesus Christ. At the time he was betrayed and entered willingly into his passion, he took bread, and giving thanks, broke it and gave it to his disciples, saying, Take this, all of you, and eat of it, for this is my body, which will be given up for you. In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took the chalice, and once more giving thanks, he gave it to his disciples, saying, Take this, all of you, and drink from it. For this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me.
Please stand.
The mystery of faith.
Save us, Savior of the world, for by your cross and resurrection you have set us free.
Therefore, as we celebrate the memorial of his death and resurrection, we offer you, Lord, the bread of life and the chalice of salvation, giving thanks that you have held us worthy to be in your presence and minister to you. Humbly we pray that partaking of the body and blood of Christ, we may be gathered into one by the Holy Spirit. Remember, Lord, your church is spread throughout the world and bring her to the fullness of charity. Together with Francis, our Pope, and Jose, our Bishop, and all the clergy. Remember also our brothers and sisters who have fallen asleep in the hope of the resurrection, and all who have died in your mercy. Welcome them into the light of your face. Have mercy on us all, we pray, that with the Blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, with Blessed Joseph, her spouse, with the blessed apostles and all the saints who have pleased you throughout the ages, we may merit to be co-heirs to eternal life and may praise and glorify you through your Son, Jesus Christ. Through him and with him and in him, O God, Almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours forever and ever.
Amen.
At the Savior's command, informed by divine teaching, we dare to say, Our Father,
who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil.
Deliver us, Lord, we pray, from every evil. Graciously grant peace in our days, that by the help of your mercy, we may be always free from sin and safe from all distress, as we await the blessed hope and the coming of our Savior, Jesus Christ.
For the kingdom, the power, and the glory are yours, now and forever.
Lord Jesus Christ, you said to your apostles, Peace I leave you, my peace I give you. Look not on our many sins, but on the faith of your church, and graciously grant her peace and unity in accordance with your will, who live and reign forever and ever.
Amen.
The peace of the Lord be with you always.
And with your spirit.
Let us offer each other the sign of peace.
Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world. Have mercy on us. Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world. Have mercy on us. Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world. Grant us peace. Please kneel.
Behold the Lamb of God. Behold him who takes away the sins of the world. Blessed are those called to the supper of the Lamb.
Lord, I am not worthy that you should enter under my roof, but only say the word, and my soul shall be healed. Please stand.
Let us pray. Renewed by this Paschal sacrament, we pray, O Lord, that we who honor the memory of the mother of your Son may show forth in our mortal flesh the life of Jesus, who lives and reigns forever and ever.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
And may Almighty God bless you, the Father, and the Son, and the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
The Mass is ended. Go in the peace of Christ.
Thanks be to God.
Hallelujah.